We will see how the can help enhance surfaces and textures. We do this by making shadows. You might think that shadows should be avoided, but it is the presence of shadows that gives us the information on the quality of a surface. However, shadows shouldn't be accidental. They should be planned by the careful selection of the light source and its positioning. The fundamental lesson about shadows is that they depend on the direction of view relative to the light source. Here are the shadows of the ducks because the sun is coming from the opposite direction to the camera. Lighting this wall from a distance with spotlights will create shadows because the spotlight is coming from below and we are looking horizontally toward. Shadows here will be soft. Moving the lights closer increases the strength and depth of the shadows. But as we get really close to the wall, the individual spotlights start to create scallops over the surface. Now the lighting is imposing its own structure over our wall. Grazing light from a linear source enables us to create the strongest shadows with even light across the surface. Grazing light is just reproducing what we see in the natural world. As the sun moves across the sky, so we see surfaces evenly illuminated, but with shadows that increase in depth the lower the sun gets. We can use this information to inform our design when we select light direction and colour. Light on this castle creates no shadows, so it looks lifeless. There is no contrast or bright areas to catch the eye, and the surface texture appears flat. Grazing light close to the base of this tower is creating two effects. Firstly, it's revealing the texture of the surface by creating miniature shadows that tell you a lot about the materials and construction. Secondly, the decoration is highlighted around the top, adding interest to the overall appearance. It's as though the tower has been given a hat. By using grazed light wherever the observer stands, you can be sure that the angle between the direction of light and the viewing direction will ensure shadows are created. Exactly the same principle applies to interior surfaces where grazing light can be used to enhance the designer's use of materials. Lighting surfaces isn't just to reveal their texture, it can also impact on the way the space looks and feels. This bridge across a lake by day feels like part of an open space. At night, light grazing up its vertical surfaces changes the whole feel of the space, creating vertical boundaries between the bridge and its surroundings. We have seen how grazing light can bring an extra dimension to our design by enhancing materials and surfaces. Lit walls can also create boundaries to spaces, changing their character by night.